Let us continue with our lesson. So what we have done is we have successfully created our migration and also the user profile model over here. And what I will do is next step is to I will go to the controller over here. Let us make use of the auth controller for now, and later we'll create a user profile when we actually go and edit the user profile from our application. But for now, let's make use of the auth controller. And on the auth controller, what I will do is whenever we create or whenever the user get registered, we will create our default user profile for the user. So when a user get registered and is create, whenever we create a user, we go and create a default profile for that particular user. So over here, let's go and say create a DFA on the default user. PROFILE profile, and what I will do is if we will check the condition, that is the if it is user, which means that the user has successfully created, then I will go and create a user profile. So let's create a variable for PROFILE profile is equals to new and say our user profile. So we have a user profile. And after we have a user profile, now we can access all of the properties for this user profile. So we can say profile, say PROFILE profile, and we have a profile.userid. So first of all, we have to save the user ID, which equals to the current user dot ID. User ID that we have previously created over here. So when the user is created, we have the access to that particular user ID. So we'll add a user profile that user ID is equals to the current user ID that we have created. And next is the profile, and after profile, I think what we have, let's go and check the column that we have over here with this user ID, and we have a profile image. So just go and copy and save the profile image is equals to, we have to add a default profile image for now, just leave it empty. Later we'll come back over here, profile, and the next is we have a profile image path. Just copy that section, paste it over here, and for now let us leave it as empty, and later we'll come back to this section again. And next we have a bio. So over here I will say as a profile dot bio is equals to, let's give a default bio. Hey, this is my DFAULT default bio. It's okay, we can just say it's a GREH, yeah, that should be fine. So we have the bio, and finally we can go and save it. So profile, and then we can do save. Now we have saved the profile. So after the user is registered, we go and create a default profile for the user with the following field that we have. So we need to add a profile image as well as a profile path. So what we will do for now is we need to get for the image profile, we need to set the URL for that image. So let's get a base URL. So for that we will need a base URL, and on the top somewhere here, let us create a variable of a base URL. Sorry, should be URL is equals to, we need to get a base URL from our env. So it should be of env, and from the env it's your environmental file over here at .env file, and from here we will get a app URL. So just copy this one and go over here, and the app URL passed it over here. So now we have, we'll get a base URL. Just copy this, and we will go to this section somewhere here, profile path, and we need a base profile, we will set a base URL. The profile image should come to the URL, so the base URL dot and the link or the storage path link. So what we'll do is we'll just go and go to our folder over here, website. It's the directory where we are working with our project. So if you have multiple project over here, just go to the project that is belong to this project, which will be to-do. And inside this to-do, what we will do is we'll go to the storage, and on the storage from we'll go to the app, and on the app we'll go to the public. So on the public, I will create a new folder over here, and I'll say as a file profile image. Sorry, img profile image. And inside this profile image, we will add some default profile image for the user. So let's go and search from our default image profile. Let's go to browser and let's search for the FAU default profile profile image. So let's try to download some of the image. And yeah, we have some profile image. You can just go and search, and depending on your requirement, you can just download any of the, okay, so you can just search any of this one. And let me just search a simple one for now. I think I'll just go with this one, and let me try to download this one. Just save it, and I can just say as a default profile. So I have something already over here, so let me just save that one. Okay, so I have downloaded, and I'll just copy that file, and I'll copy this file. And what I will do is I'll go to my previous profile image folder over here and paste that one. So we have a default profile, which is a PNG. So the location over here, you can see the storage app public profile image. So let's go back to the PHP strum over here, and here we will set the profile image part. So it should be on the storage, so storage storage, and on the storage we have a profile profile image, and the profile image we have a, if you go to profile image, and we have a default, let's rename it default profile, let's copy this, and it's a PNG file. So you may be wondering that why we are placing that storage profile image and default profile image, but if you go to that folder, it's the link is quite different. So it's, you can see that storage app public and profile image. So where is this app and the public? So I will show it later. Well, where we will set that one, we need to set a symlink link, so that will actually point to that directory. So this directory, so this is a private directory, and later we'll make it available from our, if you go back to the over here website and go to storage, and on the public, which is available for the publicly available file. So here we'll create a link back to that folder, so back to this folder that we have in the storage and app and the public. So over here we'll create a link for that one. So for now, that's why we are making use of this storage profile image and the default profile image. And for the profile image path, we'll just copy the path over here. Just copy this path and just paste it over here. So we have our default path as a default profile image. So let's go and work with the symlink. Okay, so let's go to the file storage in the Laravel section. And over here we will have to run this command, so the PHP artisan storage link. So you can see the public disk, which is intended for a file that are going to be publicly accessible. So by default, the public disk uses are local driver and storage. This file is stored in a storage app public. So this is the file that we have, storage app public. So you can see the link storage app public. And we have created a profile image inside that one. So to make this, make them accessible from the web, you should create a symbolic link. So we need to create a symbolic link from the public storage to the storage app public. So we need to create this symbolic. So how do we create is to run this PHP artisan command. So just copy this command and let's go back to the project, and on the terminal just paste that code. So PHP artisan storage link, that will create a link for us. And so it said the public storage directory has been created. So now if you go back over here and let's go to the web and go to your project, and on the public now if you go, we have a we have created a storage link over here, which is a storage, and now we have that, folder. So this is how we create a symbolic link, and that is publicly accessible, this folder. And actually that folder relies on a storage, so storage app and public and in the profile image. So this is the actual directory that we are saving our file, but we have created a symbolic link to the, if you go to public, and in the public we have storage, and there is the folder that we have created. And before we close up, let us commit everything. So git add dot, so it will add everything for us, and I will just say git, and I will say commit commit dash m, and I will say added if you can see the function for user profile in, we say auth controller. So that's it, and let's go and use a VCS to go to git and push it. So when we push it, we see that we just committed, and let's push it. So that will go and publish it to our GitHub. So that's all for this lesson, and hope you guys got it, what we are actually trying to do over here. And let's meet up in the next lecture. Till then, have a great day.